McCoy Gar. Greetings, I am Tad Larkin, the lore master of Mandalore. And today I'm going to be digging through the archives to elaborate on the pressure suit encased Skakoans. Skakoans evolved on the core world of Skako, a methane-rich terrestrial world in which the Skakoans transformed into an Inukinopolis, dense enough to rival, say, Coruscant. They are often characterized by their rather bulky pressure suits that they are required to wear when they're any place but their home world, due to Skako's high-pressure environment and methane-rich atmosphere. If you were to see a Skakoan without their suit, which is a rare sight among non-Skakoans, you would notice a tall biped with grayish-white to green skin pigment, no lips, and small, beady eyes. Skakoans also lacked teeth, due to their mostly liquid diet, and they could live up to an average of 99 to 110 galactic standard years. Due to their planet's unique conditions, Skakoans rarely traveled from their homeworld, but when they did, they would have to don those bulky pressure suits that I mentioned earlier. The suits not only maintained a similar atmospheric pressure to replicate their homeworld, but reinforced tubes throughout the suit supplied a steady stream of methane to the Skakoan. Because of these cumbersome suits, as well as the extreme yet rational fear of explosive decompression if the suit were to ever be breached, most Skakoans stayed on Skako. There has never been a recorded Force-sensitive Skakoan, and whether the species is completely incapable of using the Force, or just no members of the species ever discovered the potential within themselves, we may never know. Skakoans were highly xenophobic, distrustful of any non-Skakoans, and their society was very organized, almost bureaucratic in a sense. Though most Skakoans spoke the Galactic Basic Standard, their own language was known as Skako-verbal, and it can only be described as a mix between Bocce and Binary, a very mechanical-sounding language. The written form of Skako-verbal was Skako-form, and it exhibited many of the machine-like qualities of its spoken form, with its characters strongly resembling circuit board diagrams. Skakoans were very self-centered, and self-preservation was ranked high in Skakoan society, and their relentless logic and mathematical tendencies allowed them to solve a multitude of problems, technological applications being their preferred method. Although logic and science were very important to Skakoan society, they did possess a religion based on the Book of Bulmide, where elders of the Power Mounds worshipped and revered a being known as the Albino Cyclops. Skako, and by extension Skakoans, weren't discovered until the blazing of the Hydean Way, during the establishment of the Brentall-Denon Route, and before the establishment of the Galactic Republic. Though Skakoans preferred to stay out of galactic affairs, they did eventually attain membership in the Galactic Republic, and because of their reverence for technology, they became heavily involved in, and later began to lead, the Techno Union. In 22 BBY, the Techno Union led by Foreman Wat Tambor signed Count Dooku's Treaty, and became one of the founding members of the Confederacy of Independent Systems, effectively seceding from the Republic. The Clone War soon broke out, and while the rest of the Techno Union member planets were contributing to the CIS war effort, Skako itself was effectively blockaded by the First Sector Army, due to its close proximity to Coruscant, and it remained so until the Republic pushed the CIS fully out of the core 2 years and 6 months into the war. The Techno Union was responsible for pretty much the entire CIS military, given its overall control of Bactoid Armor Workshops, Bactoid Combat Automata, and Hayar Chal Engineering. Those companies mainly only fell under the Techno Union's umbrella, making the only direct military contributions of the Techno Union the LM-432 Crab Droid, the Octopatara Combat Tri-Droid, the Octopatara Manga Tri-Droid, the Heart Cell Class Transport, and the Bulwark Mark I Battlecruiser. The Techno Union also spearheaded CIS military research and development, crafting creative solutions to imposing problems, such as the lightsaber-proof CB-3 series Cortosis battle droids, which were destroyed by Anakin Skywalker early in the war. On Nelvan, the Techno Union experimented with integrating the native Nelvanians with cybernetic implants, taking the men from neighboring tribes and turning them into mindless slave soldiers. These efforts were again thwarted by Skywalker, when, in 19 BBY, shortly before the battles of Tyth and Coruscant, he stumbled upon upon the Techno-Union installation on Nelvon while on a spiritual journey, and he discovered where the males of the Nelvonian tribes were being kept. Witnessing their grotesque transformations at the hands of the Skakoan technicians, Anakin managed to free the Nelvonians, having them turn on their Skakoan slave masters, and, with their aid, he destroyed the Techno-Union installation, which, in turn, began reversing the adverse climate changes on Nelvon. Following the death of Wat Tambor on Mustafar at the end of the Clone Wars, the Techno-Union was liquidated by the newly established Galactic Empire, and the Skakoans were persecuted for their involvement with the CIS. Most Skakoans resumed their isolationist stance at that point, keeping out of the Galactic Civil War, Yuuzhan Vong War, Swarm War, and Second Galactic Civil War, though some Skakoans did venture from their home world, such as the bounty hunter Harim Mawar. Skakoans later found themselves under the control of Darth Krayt's Galactic Empire and 127 ABY, though the Skakoans made no contributions to Krayt's war effort whatsoever. This ends my findings on Skakoans. If you have any suggestions for future transmissions, don't be afraid to drop a comment. In the meantime, keep your comm channels open for future transmissions, and don't forget to subscribe! Tabarkin, out.